Our next topic is a large number of simple harmonic motions of same angular frequency with different amplitudes and phases. Here, instead of two simple harmonic motions, we are superimposing a large number of simple harmonic motions. A number of simple harmonic motions are superimposed here. Like in the previous case, here angular frequencies of all of the simple harmonic motions are same, but they have different amplitudes and phases. Okay. We consider the displacement of the simple harmonic, first simple harmonic motion is x1 is equal to a1 sin omega t plus phi 1. It is sin omega t plus phi 1 is sin omega t cos phi 1 plus cos omega t sin phi 1. Using sin a plus b is equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. Okay, therefore x1 is equal to a1 sin omega t cos phi 1 plus cos omega t sin phi 1 is the displacement in the case of first simple harmonic motion. Similarly, displacement of the second simple harmonic motion is x2 is equal to a2 sin omega t plus phi 2, that is a2 sin omega t cos phi 2 plus cos omega t sin phi 2. In similar way, we can write displacement of the third, fourth, fifth, and up to nth simple harmonic motions, we are going to superimpose. Okay, so we superimpose a number of simple harmonic motions of which a displacement are given here. Okay, then applying principle of superposition, we can find the resultant displacement of the harmonic motion produced due to the superposition of these simple harmonic motions. The resultant displacement is x is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus etc plus xn. According to the superposition principle, we obtain the resultant displacement like this. Okay. So x is equal to a1 sin omega t plus phi 1 plus a2 sin omega t plus phi 2 plus a3 sin omega t plus phi 2 plus etc plus an sin omega t plus phi n. Okay, using summation, it can be written as x is equal to sigma n is mod n is equal to 1 to capital N an sin omega t plus phi n. Okay, we know what about this summation. Here, first small n reads 1. Okay, therefore, first we get a1 in place of n, we can give 1. Therefore, we get a1 sin omega t plus phi 1 plus. Okay, then small n reads 2. a2 sin omega t plus phi 2 plus. Then it reads 3. a3 sin omega t plus phi 3 plus etc. It reads up to capital N. Small n reads up to capital N, and the final term will be a capital N sin omega t plus phi capital N. Okay, this summation gives the sum of these terms a1 sin omega t plus phi 1 plus a2 sin omega t plus phi 2 plus a3 sin omega t plus phi 3 plus etc plus an sin omega t plus phi n. It can indicate by this summation. Okay, therefore x is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to capital N an sin omega t plus phi n. Okay, that is x is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to n an sin omega t cos phi n plus cos omega t sin phi n. Okay, it indicates the sum of these terms given in the right hand side. First term will obtain if n reads 1, that is a1 sin omega t cos phi 1 plus cos omega t sin phi 1, this term. Then plus summation plus, then n reads 2, a2 sin omega t cos phi 2 plus cos omega t sin phi 2, this term plus. Ok, generates 3 A3 sin omega t cos phi 3 plus cos omega t sin phi 3 plus etc. plus finally generates capital N. N is equal to 1 to N. Okay, finally generates capital N. Therefore, we get this term. A capital N sin omega t cos phi capital N plus cos omega t sin phi capital N. Okay. This summation indicates the sum of these terms given in the right hand side. That is the resultant displacement here. Therefore, resultant displacement x is equal to sigma small n is equal to 1 to capital A n sin omega t cos phi 1 phi n plus cos omega t sin phi n. Sin omega t can be taken outside from this summation because no small n here. Okay. So x is equal to sin omega t sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n cos phi n plus cos omega t can be taken outside from the second term. Therefore, cos omega t sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n sin phi n. Okay. Let sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n cos phi n is equal to r cos theta because it is sum of cosine terms. Sum of cosine terms always equal to another cosine term or cosine function. Okay, sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n cos phi n is equal to r cos theta here, and sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n sin phi n is equal to r sin theta. Sum of sine functions will give another sine function. Okay, then x is equal to sin omega t r cos theta plus cos omega t r sin theta. Okay, sin omega t r cos theta plus cos omega t r sin theta. Okay, that is r can be taken outside from both of these things terms because it is common. X is equal to r sin omega t cos theta plus cos omega t sin theta. Okay, that is the resultant displacement in r. X is equal to r sin omega t plus theta because sin omega t cos theta plus cos omega t sin theta is in the form of sin a cos b plus cos a sin b, that is equal to sin a plus b. Okay, applying that here we get x is equal to r sin omega t plus theta. It is the resultant displacement in the case of the harmonic motion obtained due to the superposition of these large number of simple harmonic motions of same angular frequency with a different amplitudes and a phase. Okay, here r is the amplitude of the resultant harmonic motion obtained. We can find it as in the previous case. In order to find r, we have to squaring and adding both of these equations. Okay, we have to squaring and adding sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n cos phi n is equal to r cos theta and sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n sin phi n is equal to r sin theta. Therefore, on right hand side we will get r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. R square is common, can be taken outside. Remaining parts are cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, we will get the r square on right hand side. On left hand side, we will get the sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n cos phi n phi n whole square plus sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n sin phi n whole square. Okay. Therefore, we will get, if we squaring and adding both of these equations, we will get the r square is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n cos phi n whole square plus sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n sin phi n whole square. Okay. Therefore, r is equal to square root of sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n cos phi n whole square plus sigma n is equal to 1 to n a n sin phi n whole square. That is the amplitude of the resultant harmonic motion obtained here. Okay, similarly we can find the initial phase of the resultant simple harmonic motion. For that we can divide this first equation, we can divide this second equation by the first equation. Okay, therefore on right hand side you will get r sin theta by r cos theta, that is equal to tan theta. On left hand side we will get sigma n is equal to 1 to an sin phi n divided by sigma n is equal to 1 an cos phi n. Therefore we will get tan theta is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to an sin phi n divided by sigma n is equal to 1 to an cos phi n. Okay, from this we will get the initial phase of the resultant harmonic motion due to the superposition of these large number of simple harmonic motions. Theta is equal to tan inverse sigma n is equal to 1 to an sin phi n divided by sigma n is equal to 1 to n cos phi. Okay. Our next topic is superposition of two harmonic oscillations with a different frequencies to give amplitude modulated oscillation. Okay. Here we superimpose two harmonic oscillations with a different frequencies. The amplitudes are same, but the frequencies are different. Suppose displacement of the first harmonic motion is psi 1 is equal to a cos omega 1 t. A cos omega t plus phi is the general equation for harmonic motion, but here we take initial phase phi is equal to 0. Therefore, displacement of the first harmonic motion is given by psi 1 is equal to a cos omega 1 t plus cos omega 1 t. Initial phase is 0. In the second simple harmonic motion also, we consider initial phase is 0. Okay, phase angle phi is equal to 0. Therefore, the displacement in the case of simple harmonic, second simple harmonic motion is given by psi 2 is equal to a cos omega 2. Here amplitudes are same a, and frequencies are different in omega 1 and omega 2. Okay. We have to superimpose both of these simple harmonic motion. Then we get another simple harmonic motion as the resultant. Okay. The resultant displacement can be found using superposition principle. By applying superposition principle, we can find the displacement of the resultant harmonic motion. Okay, that resultant displacement is psi of t is equal to psi 1 plus psi 2. Sum of the displacements of the individual harmonic motions. That is, psi of t is equal to psi 1 a cos omega 1 t plus psi 2 a cos omega 2 t. Okay. A is common, can be taken outside. Psi of t is equal to a into cos omega 1 t plus cos omega 2 t. We know the mathematical relation. Cos a cos b is equal to 2 cos a plus b by 2 cos a minus b by 2. Here, in place of a, omega 1 t, omega 2 t is in the place of b. Okay. Therefore, cos omega 1 t plus cos omega 2 t is cos omega 1 t plus omega 2 t by 2 cos omega 1 t minus omega 2 t by 2. Okay, is common in both of the terms, can be taken outside. Therefore, psi of t is equal to a 2 cos 2 into a 2 a 2 a cos omega 1 plus omega 2 t by 2 cos omega 1 minus omega 2 by 2 into t. Okay, psi of t is equal to 2a cos omega 1 plus omega 2 t by 2 cos omega 1 minus omega 2 t by 2. Here, omega 1 plus omega 2 by 2 is equal to omega a, which is the average frequency here. Omega 1 minus omega 2 by 2 is omega mod, that is modulation frequency here. If we take their sum, take the sum of omega and omega a, we get omega a plus omega mod, that is equal to omega 1 minus omega 2 by 2 plus omega 1 plus omega 2 by 2 minus omega 1 by 2 plus omega 2 by 2 reduced to 0. Therefore, answer is omega 1 by 2 plus omega 1 by 2, that is omega 1. Similarly, if we subtract omega mod from omega a, omega av minus omega mod, omega 1 by 2 minus omega 1 by 2 reduced to 0, omega 2 by 2 minus minus omega 2 by 2, that is omega 2 by 2 plus omega 2 by 2, that is omega 2. Omega av minus omega mod is equal to omega 2. Okay. If we substitute equations 2 and equation 3 in equation 1, okay, equation 1, in place of omega 1 plus omega 2 by 2, we substitute omega av in the place of omega 1 minus omega 2 by 2, we substitute omega mod. Then we will get 2a cos omega av t by 2 cos omega mod t. Okay, 2a cos omega av t cos omega mod t.
positions of both these cosecants can be interchanged. Therefore, we'll get 2a cos omega mod t cos omega avt. So, yos is equal to 2a cos omega mod t cos omega avt. Okay. This term 2a cos omega mod t is the amplitude here. Okay. 2a cos omega mod t is the amplitude here, which is a function of time. Therefore, 2a cos omega mod t is equal to a mod of t, which is a function of time. It's the amplitude part here. It varies with the time. Okay. Then cos omega avt is the phase part here. Therefore, the supplement is displacement then becomes psi of t is equal to a mod of t cos omega avt. Which means here resultant motion is such a motion. This, of course, simple harmonic with a time varying amplitude a mod of t and with an angular frequency omega a. Okay, so we get a resultant motion which is simple harmonic in nature with a time varying amplitude a mod of t and a frequency omega a. That is omega 1 minus omega 2 by 2. If angular frequencies of both of these simple harmonic motion, which we superimpose, are nearly equal. If omega 1 approximately equal to omega, is equal to omega, then omega AV is omega plus omega by 2, that is 2 omega by 2, that is omega. Omega 1 minus omega 2 by 2 omega 1, omega minus omega by 2 nearly equal to 0. Therefore, omega AV, okay, omega AV very much greater than omega mod here. Okay, omega AV very much greater than omega mod here, or omega mod very much less than omega AV. Omega mod very much less than omega AV. Omega mod nearly equal to 0. Therefore, cos 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, psi of t is equal to 2a cos omega AVt is the resultant displacement. 2a cos omega AVt. 2a constant amplitude. Omega A is the frequency. Okay. It means if angular frequencies of both of these simple harmonic motions are nearly equal, we get such a harmonic motion with a constant amplitude and an angular frequency of omega A. Constant amplitude harmonic motions are usually known as simple harmonic motion. Okay. Therefore, we will get a simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion with the angular frequency omega a. But amplitude is not a perfectly a constant a, because omega 1 not exactly equal to omega 2. Amplitude term is time varying here. Amplitude is varying accordance with the frequency of the wave superimposed. Here amplitude of the resultant wave changes in accordance with the frequency of the waves we superimpose. Amplitude is changing due to this superposition. Okay. So it is amplitude modulation.